Well, I think what we've seen, we've all been shocked and horrified by what happened in Mumbai and what's happened in Lahore recently. But frankly, it's not completely new. We've seen attacks across the globe now for more than 10 years, horrifying in the scale of loss of life, in their viciousness, in the ruthlessness, and in the complete indifference as to whether innocent people are killed. So there's nothing new. Before 9/11, when we were thinking about plans and exercises, we didn't think the unthinkable because that sometimes took away credibility from the exercise. Since 9/11, we've had to think the unthinkable. So I think that's what we need to do. We need to go beyond what we've experienced and think what else could happen and prepare for that, both mentally and physically. If we're going to be in a position to protect the public from totally ruthless terrorists who will commit suicide in order to launch their attacks and don't care who or how many people they kill, we have to make sure that not only are the forces of law and order in good shape to meet that threat, but that the laws themselves are adequate, that communities understand what has to be done, and that politicians and the courts and the judges are all aware of their responsibilities and what needs to be done in support of public safety. We know that there's a linkage between terrorism in the United Kingdom and training camps in Afghanistan and the border region. Jonathan Evans, the head of MI5, recently said that some 75% of terrorist plots that are being investigated in the UK have a link to Pakistan. And of course, that's inevitable given the linkages that there are between the United Kingdom and Pakistan, people with families. There are many, many innocent people who have links with Pakistan, but that can act as a cover for the more sinister activities of some terrorists. So yes, we have to be concerned if a West Midlands accent is intercepted somewhere, but it's no surprise.